Derek, I don't know if you could hear what Sitaram Yechuri was saying there just now about what the opposition needs to do in 2019. He believes it's not idealistic to talk about no face versus Narendra Modi, that it has to be issue-based, and it also has to be about the opposition giving people a positive alternate vision apart from attacking the government. And it's not going to be enough to attack the BJP. You agree with that broadly?
Well, firstly, I think the message from that Gujarat result is very, very clear. From the body language in parliament today, from the general buzz, I'm talking even about non-political people. You know, you go and have lunch somewhere, you talk to the waiters in the restaurant and they'll tell you what their take was. But I think before that, Nidhi, we need to, as Mamtadi put it so beautifully yesterday, we need to congratulate the voters of Gujarat because they've really delivered a balanced verdict. And it's no doubt, it's a temporary win, it's a face saver, and it's a moral defeat for the BJP. They don't want to see it that way, but that's something else. And what have people voted against in Gujarat? And I think that's the bigger message, because I think they voted against atrocities, they voted against an anxiety, they voted against injustice. And as Mamtadi put it very beautifully yesterday, the people of Gujarat have belled the cat for the 2019 elections. So we have match on, and we've been saying this for a while. The Trinamool have been saying this inside parliament and outside parliament and every block meeting in Bengal for a long while now, that the BJP is beatable in 2019.
But Derek, you know, when you say that this is a temporary win for the BJP, when Mamata Banerjee says it's a temporary win, you called it a moral defeat, a face saver. Look, in politics, some would argue that what is a moral defeat? After all, a win is a win. And look, they've been in power for 22 years, huge anti-incumbency, huge protests, economy had, you know, certain issues, but they're still back in power. I mean, it is quite remarkable to win a sixth consecutive term.
You see, as much as they want to look at the glass as half full or half empty, but the bottom line is, where were we playing this match? We were playing this match at the political backyard of the national president of the BJP and the Prime Minister of India. And if you look at it, if this election was not held in two phases, you know, the result could have been very, very different. I'll stick my neck out and say, if this election was held in one phase on day one without the gap between phase two, then the BJP were a goner. As far as I'm concerned, they're already a goner, because you're fighting in your home state, in your backyard. You've used every, not only the agencies to help you through this, you've broken institutions to help you through this. You've done everything possible and you've squeaked past the post. Because yesterday we saw the results, and today as a student of politics, we were actually studying those results. And some of those margins, you know, some of those margins, this is this Gujarat ki asmita that may have worked and pushed them over the line in Gujarat. But I can tell you, the BJP, I've said this before, Mamata Di has said this before, we are convinced, and I'm glad we've been talking about this for the last 6 months, they are goners in 2019. So I heard some of the your question as to who will be the face and who will not be the face. That's not important. That's not important. The BJP have broken this, or attempting to break institutions of this country, the very moral fabric of this, the social fabric of this country, and that's the message of Gujarat.
But Derek, when
below 200 seats,
it's okay. You're saying, so you're saying there are goners, as you put it, in 2019. But the fact is that the Prime Minister's personal popularity is very high. Look, whatever the reason, he went and campaigned the way that he did in Gujarat,
and they won.
I'm saying,
when you say
how
Prime
can the opposition say it can't have a face to take on Narendra Modi?
When you say Prime Minister's personal popularity, what are you referring to? Let me give you three stats. If you are referring to the Prime Minister's WhatsApp, app, which gives the votes and says 74% approval rating, are you referring to that? Or are you referring to some internet poll which was conducted by the world's largest English newspaper saying 80% give him an approval rating? The more important statistic is 17% of Indians only want this Prime Minister to continue. This is not my figure. This is the reality. If you look at the people who didn't vote, the percentage of vote which the BJP got, so we're looking at 17-18%. As far as I'm concerned, it's not going to be easy. The opposition have a job to do. But from now, from today, starting from today, first day in Parliament, right up to the Karnataka elections, after that, we've got Panchayat elections in Bengal. That's a little bit of a walk in the park for us. But after that, you'll just see what will happen and how this will build up into 2019.
Is Rahul Gandhi, you think, the man around whom the opposition can unite? As a leader, as a potential leader of an alliance going into the next election?
No. See, Nidhi, again, this is not the time. This is the time we are talking about winning a match. This is not the time we are discussing who became the new Congress president and we should wish him the best of luck. You know, there are people, there are a lot of experienced leaders in this pack, many experienced leaders with a lot of credentials, with a lot of credibility. They're tried and tested. They fought people's movements for 3-4 decades. And if you're thinking that I'm hinting to Mamata these credentials, of course, look at her credentials.
What else would I think?
As we speak today, 2006, this was, I think, day 15 or day 16 of a 26-day fast. What about all those struggles? So there's a lot of experience. There's a lot of credentials. There's a lot of credibility. There's a lot of all this on board. So please don't bring this down to a discussion about particular person A or B.
But it's interesting that you say that. You're saying that why it's not just Rahul Gandhi, that Mamata Banerjee is as much in the reckoning to lead an anti-BJP opposition alliance in 2019. That's what you're saying. That's interesting.
Let me put it to you quite bluntly. For the last 1 year, Bengal has been playing a leading role. I'm talking about contemporary. Bengal has been playing a leading role for the last many hundred years. But for the last 1 year specifically, especially when Mamata ji has gone to a second term, Bengal has been playing a leading role, not only in a political role, but if you look at the parameters of what how Bengal is doing on development, on social infrastructure, on all those issues. That's number one. Number two, who called demonetization first? Who called GST first?
Mamata Banerjee.
Who called net neutrality first? All three. Tick, tick, tick. Mamata ji. Now, Bengal is going to play a big role between now to 2019, and Bengal will play a leading role in the formation of the government in 2019. You be rest assured.
All right. Well, very, very interesting news point from you there, Derek O'Brien. And before we go, can I just ask you, is there a strategy that the opposition has to come together in Parliament now that it's finally started? Any plans to come together on certain key issues?
Well, I'm not the spokesperson for the opposition. I'm only the spokesperson for the Trinamool, and I'm enjoying my role.
Okay, but
Trinamool's view in Parliament is very clear. Yeah, it's a short session. Wrong time, called only after this election. But within this time, we have to use every minute, every hour to make the government answerable. So we would like Parliament to run. We would want discussion and debate. Today in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, the Trinamool had, I think, about 12 different interventions. If you take questions, 0 hour, all that together. We want Parliament to run. This is a great opportunity to put this government on the back foot, because when it comes to discussing policy on the floor of Parliament, they run away from Parliament. Come, discuss in Parliament. If they really want to have a discussion on any of these issues we've raised, be it Aadhaar, today FRDI bill, be it jobs, be it economy, all this, we will have them, we will eat them for Christmas pudding if they come to have a discussion.
All right, Derek O'Brien, thanks very much for joining us this evening. Enjoy your Christmas pudding. Enjoy your Christmas. At least I don't think you have any fringe groups threatening you in Bengal at the moment or not to celebrate Christmas. Thanks very much for joining us.